Welcome to the February 2019 strategic case study analysis. Today we will be doing the analysis on a company called Vita. This company usually produces wearable fitness devices. Now, everyone, wearable fitness devices. When I say this, the thing that should come into your head is Fitbit. I think you are aware about this device, Fitbit. This looks like a watch and it can also be used as a watch, but it will track the number of steps you have taken in a day, the calories, what you have burnt in a day. So this is a device that will be tracking your fitness. So our company Vita is producing a device similar to this. So before we start analyzing, I would like you to tell that please be aware of the subject P3, which is the risk management, because a risk may be one of the key factor in the strategic pricing. And the second thing is the E3, which is relevant for the business knowledge, and F3, which is the technical area in the strategic level, financial strategy. Okay, everyone. Now let's start going through the analysis of this company Vita. They are telling wearable technology overview. That means this is a business skill. Please keep that in mind. The wearable fitness and activity tracker market, again business skill. Key drivers of growth in the wearable fitness and activity tracker, again business skill. Latest development in the market, again business skill. Background of history of Vita, business, people, and then leadership. Product launch timeline and sales revenue graph, this may be a business skill and also a little bit of technical knowledge also. And technology is purely a business skill. Viva's products and services, business skill. Examples of visual display on Vita's tracking devices, again business skill. Manufacturing and sales process, business. People and also leadership. Competitive environment, business plus people skill. Summary of key competitor, business, people skill. Vita's share graph, business skill. Extracts from Vita's integrated report. I'm going to underline this integrated report. So this is a topic of F3, integrated reporting. So just be aware about that topic of example G4 guideline, GRI, and there is something called value creation. Value creation process is also there. Just be aware about that, because they can test an area on that, on the application part. And they have mentioned risk register. This is a P3 topic for sure. Stakeholder engagement, business, people and business skill. And this is the value creation also they are given. Senior leadership skill, teams they are given. That is the business, people and leadership. And then annual report of financial statement, which is again business, people and leadership. Okay. Now everyone, let's start going through the analysis. Vita. You are the senior manager, senior finance manager of Vita. So as per the pre-seen history, this is the same role what has been repeated for the last 3 years. A consumer's electronic company. Again, it's a consumer electronic company. Vita designs and sells wireless-enabled wearable fitness and activity tracker devices that measure wide range of personal metrics related to fitness and activity. Vita's headquarters are located in Newland, that is the country, a prosperous nation. So I'll put a star for this prosperous nation. So when the nation is prosperous, they will be having the affordability to buy these devices. Where a significant proportion of population take an active interest in sports and wide range of health and fitness activity. So to be frank, the opportunity is very good in this market, because the people are also very interested in fitness. You report directly to the chief financial officer of Vita and advise on special project on strategic matters. The currency is in dollars, so please keep that in mind. There can be forex risk tested in this area, so just remember the currency of our country is in dollar. Now everyone, let's move to the next area. In the next area, it's given about the wearable technology overview. Now everyone, a wearable technology is a term used for electronics that can be worn on the body, either as an accessory or as a part of material used in the clothes. There are many types of technology, for example, wrist-based fitness, an activity tracker, smart watches. So I will put here opportunity. Now the problem is currently we are not manufacturing smart watches. We are only manufacturing the fitness device where it will be tracking your fitness in the wrist. Smart shoe, this is also an opportunity. We can produce that in the future. Clothing and virtual reality headset. One of the major features of wearable technology, its ability to connect to the internet, enabling data to be exchanged between the device and network to enable data detailed analysis. The growing popularity of mobile network has been one of the most major factors in the development of wearable technology. So the mobile devices is also one chance. So there can be a merger also. One of the largest mobile phone company, telecommunication provider, can buy your own company. For example, I think you may be knowing there is a company called Xiaomi. In other words, they say MI. That is a mobile phone company. And also this company is manufacturing fitness trackers also. They have the MI fitness trackers also, which is a low end. Therefore, high chances there can be an acquisition taking place of our company by another big player. So please keep that in mind. The acquisition part also can come. Following the case material focus on wrist-based fitness and activity tracker segment of wearable technology. That means we are just producing the wrist-based fitness technology. A wearable fitness and activity tracker. Wearable fitness and activity trackers are wireless-enabled devices that monitor and record person's fitness and activity. They are designed to monitor the track activity related to metrics such as number of steps taken, a distance walked or run, calories consumed, active minutes. In some devices, heart rate and sleep quality also. So these are the features I can say. These are the features I can say. So what you can consider here is there can be a situation where you can differentiate by having some new feature. For example, you can have a music listening app also. Sometimes while you are jogging, you can listen to music via these devices. That can also be done. Just I am telling you. So value analysis also can be tested. So just be careful with that. Military forces and medical professionals and some businesses such as security services have been using wearable technology for decades. Now here they are giving another target segment. Now actually we are producing it for B2C, business to consumers. So you can get a special order where you can produce it to the military forces also. So I can say B2B also can come here. Military forces, large hospitals also, you can get some contract. Consumer market has only been recently taken off, largely through success of wearable fitness and activity trackers. The first commercially available wearable devices designed for private consumers developed in early 2000 were little more the step counters, also known as pedometers. The only thing they count your steps only. However, the last 10 years has seen phenomenal rise in technical accuracy, usability, affordability, popularity of fitness and activity trackers. So at the moment, the growth is going up, but in the early 2000, it was just a tracker which will be monitoring your number of steps you have taken. Most fitness and activity trackers synchronize activity data to applications on smart devices. Or data can be synced to a website on a computer. Now, I am telling here. Now, if you look at these two, I am being very frank. If you compare these two, what I am telling is if they can synchronize, just keep in mind, if they can synchronize, there can be a data risk also. Suppose there can be a data risk where your data can be synchronized in a wrong manner and virus also can get attacked. The apps and the website then presents the user with the activity data in range of graphical format. They are exclusively designed to give user an insight into the overall activity and the fitness progress. The apps and the website developed by manufacturers of fitness and activity trackers also offer social dimension to sharing fitness information of tracker wearing community. Nowadays, I think you would have seen people usually share in Facebook the number of steps they have taken. It will be showing like a small map where you have been traveling. So it has become a trend of socialization also. The apps and the website often offer community page where the user can challenge themselves and compete against another user or friend who uses the same device. Much of as the appeal of fitness and activity trackers, which makes them effective tools for increasing personal fitness, comes from making exercise fun and challenging. Use of an app can serve as a mean of identification with fitness community, where users can also choose to share progress, pictures and achievement of with the community. So that is a very important thing, where this is also nowadays considered as a fitness activity. Okay. Now they are telling in the next one, it is estimated that as the end of 2018, there were 150 million active users of fitness activity trackers throughout the world. So if they are telling throughout the world, there is a high chance of international market attraction also. Nowadays, I think you have international websites. For example, like Amazon is an international website. Okay, and I think, you know, eBay is an international website. And Alibaba is also an international website. So there can be chances where you can sell your products through an online store also. An active user is defined as a registered user of a wearable fitness tracker device who within 3 months prior to the date of measurement has active subscription which has been synced with the health and fitness tracker or has logged at least 100 steps with health and fitness tracker. Now the next thing, key drivers in the fitness and activity tracker market. There are a number of factors that have contributed to the growth and fitness and activity tracker in the last 10 years. Firstly, the increase in smartphone-based fitness tracking apps as a key driver in the wearable fitness and activity tracker market. These fitness tracking apps often enhance level of functionality with design and features that can help an individual to stay fit. Due to easy accessibility and low cost, consumers are becoming more inclined towards using these apps in conjunction with fitness and activity tracking device. Moreover, the fitness tracking apps are supported by all major smartphone operating systems such as iOS and Android. So these are the activity because of smartphone only nowadays people are using this. So you need to be aware a little bit of the system operating system of Android and iOS. Secondly, in the last few years, many organizations have been conducting a fitness and health awareness and management program to reduce cost of healthcare system. For instance, non-for-profit organizations in Europe and North America have conducted various programs to increase the awareness about health and fitness issues, such as benefit of proper diet and exercise. This increasing awareness among consumers has boosted demand of fitness and activity tracker. So one more external factor that has contributed is the awareness of people getting to know about the importance of maintaining the health and fitness. So all these are opportunities in the market. The third one, technology used in the latest fitness and activity trackers is far more accurate and sophisticated than the earliest model. Design has become more lightweight and user-friendly and now seen as a fashion accessory also. Nowadays, the trend has changed. That means rather than fitness, it is a hybrid, fashion plus fitness. The range of design available and wide range of functionality has meant that fitness and activity trackers has a wide demographic appeal and used by males, females from 8 to 80 plus years. So this is a good target area. Now let's come to the technological side. The development in fitness and activity tracker market. The latest development in the fitness and activity tracker market has been the development of smartwatch. Smartwatches connected the user's phone using various wireless technologies such as Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, GPS and serve as a front-end for remote system and smartphones. A smartwatch allows users to read and respond to text, see emails, use a range of wrist-based apps. Often extension of smartphone apps themselves and provide notification from social media apps. Many of these latest smartwatches developed since 2015 now include fitness tracking technology as a standard. Exploiting the hybrid watch and the fashion accessory smartphone market is the latest major opportunities in the fitness and activity tracker. So the smartphone and the smartwatch has become one of the more key players. So there is an opportunity that you can develop a product of a smartwatch in the future. More advanced smartwatches have recently been designed to measure and monitor specific sporting activities such as running, cycling, swimming and golf. So you need to be also diversified at the moment. In 2018, global unit sales and smartwatches exceeds unit sales of fitness and activity trackers. So what is happening is smartwatches sales are going up and the fitness tracker app is going down. The reason is smartwatches have more features and fitness track is just a normal feature. So there is high chances in the exam that you will be developing a new product. So keep that in mind. Now students, let's come to the next area. This is the background and history of Vita. Vita was formed in 2011. That means it's a new startup. It's a new startup company. So keep that in mind. It's a technological company where the growth rate is really faster. By two friends, Ria Turner and Gal Yazius, who both studied information technology management at the same university in the economically developed country of Newland. Ria and Gal ran together as a members of university distance running club and often talked about turning their interest into a fitness business. It was during one of the many long run together they had an idea of developing wearable fitness and activity tracking technology that went further than basic pedometers that has been using. They considered how useful it would be to have detailed information about their run collected in an obstructive manner. Vita was founded to develop wearable devices that could offer this functionality. So initially these two people have developed with the idea of maintaining the health because they are good runners also. Vita was initially financed by low interest new technology grant offered by Newland government. So low interest means I can say adjusted present value. Now we say there is something called subsidized loan. So just keep that in mind that there can be a situation where adjusted present value can be tested. So I will write here adjusted present value, and we say adjusted present value, a short term is APV. Adjusted present value, a short term is APV. And one more thing, students, just to keep you updated, there is something called subsidized loan that will be coming in this area. So at the moment, the company has taken a subsidized loan also. Vita's first fitness acting tracker was Liber, that's a brand, was launched in 2011 and took the form of small clip-on tracker showing step, distance, calories, flow, climb, and the time. Ria and Gal sourced their products to two inexpensive contract manufacturers in Asia. So I can say there is a risk because they have gone to an inexpensive manufacturer in Asia. So what about the regulation compliance? Because I am worried that whether they are following the regulation compliances. So just be aware about that. Which were also a relatively new organization. Vita has benefited from excellent collaborative relationship with two companies since business inception, and business has grown and developed together. Liber was a great success and sales grow rapidly where the global in nature. This enabled Ria and Gal opportunity to invest and develop a more refined fitness tracker called Activus in 2013. This device offered GPS higher level of accuracy than Liber and took the form of wristband. At the same time Activus was launched, Vita launched a accompanying website and an app so that customers could easily keep track of their fitness over time. Vita's website and app are built around the control hub model. The highlighting key features of activity data would be selected by the customer. During the next few years, sales continued to grow and Vita expanded its operations accordingly. Two more fitness and activity tracker devices was launched, PAX in 2015 and Primus in 2017. And the app was further developed to take the form of personal data management. Fitness community building business was also prioritized as a part of app and website development program, allowing customers to share data with friends and fitness community when logged onto the app. In early 2017, Vita listed on the new stock exchange. So I'll write here, in 2017, they are listed in the stock exchange. So if they are listed in the stock exchange, integrated reporting is important. Corporate governance is important. Further, I can say one more thing. That is the Asian person where they are buying this raw material also has high chances of having the compliances. So just be careful, they are listed in 2017. Although no dividends has been paid since the listing. So I can also mention dividend policies also can come into the picture. Dividend policy, and they can also have an understanding of dividend policy, asking whether what type of dividend policy to be paid, scrip dividend or a large cash dividend, because they have not paid the money till now. And one more thing I need to tell you all, ethics may be a very important section here because of that Asian company what I am telling here. Although Vita has enjoyed a period of high prosperity, annual sales and growth in the now starting to slow down, with the rate of growth from 2016 to 18 significantly slower than the previous year. I can clearly say the slow is due to smartwatches. It is purely due to what? Smartwatches. Because when the smartwatches came to the market, what has happened? It has become a threat. Significantly slower than in the previous years. Rhea and Gal realized the importance of continually staying forefront by offering something new, innovative in the market, and considering the next steps they need to take to stay ahead of the competition. Vita's latest product, Chorus, was launched in mid-2018, and an activity tracker aimed at the children. That means they are targeting the small children at the moment. So the threat for them is the smartwatches that has developed. Now everyone, when you go through the next page, it is just giving you an idea about the product structures, what they have developed, and the sales also they have given in the units and the total revenue. This you can have a basic idea. Now let's come to the next page of technology. Vita has developed a range of proprietary fitness tracking device used in its devices. Technologies include finely tuned algorithm for steps counting. That means the programs, algorithms are the programs which is designed to monitor motion patterns and also most indicative to people's walking. The algorithm determines whether the motion size is large enough to set a precise threshold if motion is subsequent acceleration measurement meet the threshold. The motion would be counted as a step. In addition, a 3-axis accelerometer has been developed and built into technology to track movement in every direction. Accelerometer is a device that turns movement acceleration into digital measurement data when attached to the body. Two of Vita's latest fitness and activity trackers, Primus and Prax model, contain the latest proprietary technology, Vita Plus, which measures heart rate. Optimal sensors shine light onto the skin to measure the pulse through it. The light illuminates blood capillaries and senses the measure rates which blood is being pumped. This is also a measure of the heart. Now students, this one please don't overemphasize. Just have an idea only. They are giving the process of the device. So in the case study, this can be used but not in advance. So risk is there that the device is functioning in the lower manner. For example, there can be defects. So just be careful with that. Vita has been devised on own sleep tracking technology, whereby the fitness and activity tracker translate wrist movement into sleep patterns. Research and development. Vita spend vast amount on research and development work as an innovation critical to remain competitive and highly bid diametric market. A key driver behind Vita listing was the rise of fund required to facilitate even a high level of investment in research and development work from 2018. Just keep that in mind. Vita's products and services. Vita's products and services combine fitness and activity trackers devices with software service to give users tools they need to monitor the progress toward their health and fitness. Vita's fitness and activity tracker ranges. Vita currently designs and manufactures 5 fitness and activity tracking ranges designed to address the need of a wide range of users, from those looking simply to improve their fitness by increasing their activity level, to athletes looking to monitor all aspects of their performance. All Vita device automatically tracks users' daily steps, calories burned, distance travel, active minutes, display of real-time feedback, and encourage to become more active in their day-to-day lives. Some of the Vita's devices also measure flow climb as well as sleep duration and quality, and more advanced products track heart rate and GPS-based information such as speed, distance and exercise route. Primus also has more advanced features such as ability to receive calls, text notification from synchronized smartphones. So this is a good one according to them. So it's something a decent model they have. Now, students, you can just go through their product ranges, what they have given here. So I can mention a small thing is BCG, Boston Consultancy Group metrics, where you need to identify which product is doing well, which is their cash flow. Just a little bit of idea about that, but they have not given so much information about the breakdowns. Software and services. Vita software and services, which includes mobile apps, website, provides user with fitness, activity data, and motivational and social tools. So whatever said and done, that's a good thing, but you need to be aware how are they managing. The maintenance of software is very crucial. Vita's mobile app and website. Vita offers all users access to its mobile app and website, where users can access personalized activity data control hub featuring users' fitness data and synchronizes automatically and display data from users' fitness and activity tracker. The control hub provides users with wide range of information and analytics, including chart graphs and daily activities over the fitness progress. Both mobile app and websites are free and work with all Vita fitness and activity tracker model. Vita regularly updates and enhances the software to improve the information users. Now this updation, also you need to check the risk element, whether you are updating the right thing and whether a pilot study is done before you are doing the update. Other services, Vita recognize a key aspect of sustained goods and health fitness of stay motivated. Vita encourages its users by delivering real-time feedback, including notification, updates, personal and community fitness challenges, and workouts. The mobile app and website also offers user social features that allow them to view and participate in social feed and receive provide support for other users through specific health and fitness groups such as running, yoga, cycling, and healthy eating. Users can securely share their health and fitness information on opt-in basis with friends, family, and other parties and compete against each other on the key statistics statistics through daily and multi-day fitness challenges. In addition, users can choose to share their data with thousands of third-party apps through social networks and opt-in businesses. Now, students, this is the picture of the dashboard, what will be taking place. And one more thing, students, these informations are, they are giving about the product. So just have a basic idea. Don't do too much research on this. But what I'm telling you is do some past papers and with some analysis to this case. I will just guide you on that later. But just have an idea of this for the moment. And they are given this. Now, students, here comes the major part. That is the manufacturing and sales process. So I will just put a star for this manufacturing and sales process. Because I told you initially, their manufacturing is taking place in which country, students? Asia. A manufacturer of Vita's fitness and activity tracker is outsourced to two contract manufacturers, HJM and Force, both located in Asian country of Golandia, which assembles Vita's tracker device in their facilities. The components used in Vita's tracker devices are sourced either directly by Vita or on behalf of contract manufacturer. Component suppliers are located worldwide. Now there is a high control risk. Now the company is listed, so there may be some negative allegation. For example, if you look at Apple, they also manufacture their product in a company called Foxconn. Foxconn is a company which is in China. So just keep that in mind. This is also similar to that. The process is similar to that. Vita's operation staff coordinate relationship with contract manufacturers and component suppliers. Outsourced manufacturers enable great scale of flexibility of lower costs that could be achieved if Vita establish its own manufacturing facilities. The contract manufacturers and component suppliers are evaluated on an ongoing basis, including an assessment whether to utilize new or alternative contract manufacturers or component suppliers to improve capacity and performance. Vita has an excellent relationship with two existing contract manufacturers. These organizations have grown alongside Vita and have been supportive and helpful when operational issue has arisen. For example, they extended credit terms to assist with cash flow difficulties in early days of Vita. More recently, have rearranged production schedule to support Vita's growth and inventory has run down. In return, Vita has provided help, advice both contract manufacturer over the years, supporting the growth expansion they required to meet Vita's ever increasing demand. So at the moment, what is happening is most of their suppliers are coming to the overcapacity. So in the future, there can be situation that they may face a risk where they may have to find another supplier. They require to meet Vita's ever increasing demand. Vita is aware both suppliers are near to full capacity. That's what I'm telling you. And they may need to investigate a third source of supply in the future if two current providers cannot expand their production capacities further. Vita, this can be an unseen issue. Just keep in mind, this can be an unseen issue. So evaluating your suppliers can come here. Vita works with third-party distribution logistic partners, delivers its product to multiple locations worldwide. This allows Vita to manage order fulfillment time, reduce shipping cost, improve inventory flexibility. A small proportion of Vita's product sales are made directly towards the Vita website. So there can be high chances that in the future, this can become a major source of sales also. High chances are there because small proportion is only made via the sales. Now let's come to the sales channel. This is also very important for our exam. Vita sells full range of products through three primary sales channels. First one is retail. Vita sells its product to retail stores located over 40 countries. So can I mention here exchange risk is there? For sure there will be exchange risk. 40 countries they are there. So please be careful whether they are sourcing at their local currency, internal hedging techniques, external hedging techniques. I'll just write here hedging so you are being aware about that. It focuses on building close relationship with suppliers, working with them to sell the products in compelling manner. The second one is e-commerce. Vita's products are sold in global e-retailer sites. Okay, already they are selling it in the e-retailer site like Amazon, I think. In addition, the e-commerce sites of retailers also, the local one also. The consumer's direct channel where Vita sells products directly to consumer through its own online store, Vita.com. So the price changes also can affect because sometimes some customers may find it easier to buy directly from Vita. So there can be an issue between these two suppliers in the future because sometimes the company website may be cheaper. Competitive environment. This is where the business operates. Vita operates in a highly competitive environment. Highly competitive environment, heavy competition. Heavy competition is there. So reputation is very important, branding is very important, loyalty is very important. Please keep that in mind. Reputation, brand, loyalty, innovation is also very important because highly competitive market. So keep that in mind. Fitness and activity trackers have become extremely popular over the last 10 years. The market has grown rapidly in this time. High market and good profit margin have attracted many organizations in operate the market and rapidly continue improvement in technology, create dynamic and challenging competitive marketplace. In recent year, competitive rivalry has further increased with the evolution of smartwatches. I told you this is a threat. It's a substitute. It's a threat of substitute. Keep that in mind. Offering many of the functionalities of fitness and activity trackers as well as having additional capabilities that fitness and activity trackers do not. Smartwatches are attracted to premium wearable customers and present real threat to companies selling top range of fitness and activity trackers. The distinction between what constitutes fitness and activity trackers and which constitutes smartwatch is becoming difficult to define. This presents both opportunities and threats to the current incumbents in the market. Fitness and activity trackers add more value to the function of smartwatch, growing in the popularity as customers are increasingly demand for the wearable product. At the most basic end of the market, the competitive pressure is just as severe. Budget products from Asia are becoming popular and offer customer good entry point to the world of fitness tracking. So there is a threat or even from the cheaper product which is coming from Asia also. And currently you are manufacturing in Asia. So there is high chances that in Asia they can manufacture a duplicate of your version. So the copyrights may become an issue there. So just keep that in mind, everyone. A summary of the key competitors. Funfit is one of the competitors. Funfit, one of the first organization, was the first organization to launch wearable fitness. So they have the brand first mover advantage. That was in the market leader of terms of units sold and market share in 2018. So super good. Funfit has excellent sales growth performance every year, continually invest in product development. In 2016, Funfit successfully launched FunWatch, a smartwatch with highly innovative health and fitness tracking capabilities. The FunWatch was highly successful, although Funfit has struggled to research the product recall issues, which has damaged profit performance significantly. In 2018, Funfit made an unsuccessful bid to acquire Gopher IT. The competition authority of Funfit home country blocked the bid on the combined company, which was anti-competitive. So one thing is very important. The total quality management is very important. And one more thing, merger and acquisition is under control by the regulation authority. So just keep that in mind. This has happened in the market. Clown. Clown has been selling low cost. In other words, they are selling low cost fitness activity trackers in 2014. Although Clown has dominated sales in Asian market, products have been less popular across the rest of the world. Clown offers two models of brightly colored fitness trackers that are inexpensive to buy. Clown generates new sales regularly, launching fresh colors rather than new products. So this is a brand oriented company. In other words, low cost. And what they do is they just modify their packaging, marketing. Colors all they change. Gopher IT, and this was the company that was mentioned in the previous one, that company was trying to buy. Launching in 2015 with the focus of smartwatches with technological advanced capabilities, Gopher IT produced a high quality and good reputation for reliability performance. Gopher IT invests heavily in research and development to be forefront innovation. Gopher IT sales performance has grown rapidly, presenting a serious challenge to Funfit as market leader. Smart Heart is a recent entrant, new entrant with wearable market focusing only on smartwatches and showing impressive ability to steal market shares. Its exemption by 2016. Smart Heart uses highly interactive mobile phone application to support the fitness capabilities of smartwatches. So at the moment, most of the players in the market are going at a strategy of continuously innovating. And this is the market share graph of Vita. They have just shown what has happened. The market share of wearable markets, if you look at the market share of wearable markets, including smartwatches has gone down. But wearable market excluding smartwatches, if you look at excluding smartwatches, it's still growing because the prices are a little cheaper at the moment. Now, this is an important thing. Extracts from Vita's integrated report, they are telling the mission of the organization to design and deliver fitness and activity trackers and motivate people of all ages and ability to active health and fitness goals. Our mission is to empower and inspire people to live healthier life and healthy choices through smart technology. So the mission seems to be fine, and their only focus is on development of health. So there can be value for money also. So you need to be aware about that. Our vision is to be the leading global health and fitness social network organization dedicated to transforming people's attitude towards health and fitness. We want to empower users to become healthier and more active throughout their life. We aim to do this by developing innovative and accessible products and playing a leading role in transforming health and well-being and global community through our social networking facilities. A Vita value creation model, external influences and inputs, great awareness in the society, I told you that was given. Demand for health and fitness support services, talented people looking for rewarding career. Now, one more thing is smartwatch is also, in other words, smartphone and application is also one of the external factor that is creating a demand for this, because people are liking to see their performance in a dashboard in a smartwatch. How Vita add value? Capital, intellectual, advanced property, fitness technology, human, competent and experienced staff. Financial source from external and internal sources. That subsidized loan is also falling there. Social and relationship, strong and effective communication with key stakeholders and suppliers. Value-adding activities, utilize a global network of retailer to maximize market. investment in employee training and development, agile flexibility, organization structure, investment in latest research and development fitness, communication forum with customer, focus on future technology. Key output, a global network of committed and loyal manufacturing, high-performing people, a widespread market recognition, globally recognized brand, loyal customers, strong financial performance, and one thing I can say, positive feedback and word of mouth recommendation. Key outcome, social, customers, and financial, they have mentioned. Social, improved health and fitness society, effective society network for health concern. Customer satisfaction, inspired and connected community, returns for future investment, business project, revenue growth. Stakeholder engagement. Now, if you look at the stakeholder engagement, our stakeholders provide us with financial capital and finance our future growth. Over the last 2 years, we have built strong relationship with our shareholders through regular investor meeting, our annual general meeting, and financial reporting. Our corporate website also now contains detailed section of information to investors, which is updated quarterly. We aim to maintain strong relations trust with shareholders. We strive to continue grow in the business. So that's how they are managing the shareholders. Our people, we strive to be considered one of the best employers in our industry. So I told you that Asia can come a reason, because in Asia, the working practices is less regulated. Vita encourages an atmosphere of openness and mutual development of all our people with hierarchy. Talent management is crucial to ensuring both employee happiness and organizational structures. Without the freedom to make mistakes, learn, develop, and evolve, our people cannot continue to develop market-leading products with world-class innovation. An open-door policy for employees ensures communication remains continual for high quality. We want our employees to be inspired, adventurous, and unafraid. To ensure the ideas continue to flow, we believe to approach Vita boasts one of the lowest employee turnover rates in the world. So there can be a possibility of strikes coming also. So we don't know what can happen. Our customers, this is a very important thing, and they are telling clearly, we aim to offer the highest quality products and services to our customers. We train our retail partners. So it's again a little bit subjective. How can you do that? To understand the products in detail so that they can offer our customers with highest level of support and guidance during the buying process. Our website offers detailed information about our products, services, our customer care helpline in operation of 7 days a week. We value highly the input of our customers and regularly carry out customer service through our apps, website, gain ongoing feedback, and rating our products and services. Our suppliers, we have built strong relationship with suppliers of our components and final manufactured product. This has enabled us to maintain reliable quality delivery products of our customers. We achieve this relationship through supplier relationship management meeting and regular visit, performance audit and reports, technological conferences. It is vitally important to nurture our suppliers to ensure we look after them as much as we look after. So I can say this supplier is a question mark how they are managing, because here it's just a subjective terms they have given. And then comes the most important thing, the risk register. It's very crucial. Now I'll directly jump into the risk factor, because this has come previously also in previous cases. Now they are telling a risk description. This is P3, and I am 100% sure from P3 there can be a theme coming for sure. Slowing sales growth due to intense of increasing competition in the marketplace, particularly smartphone and smartwatch. I told you it's a threat for the organization. Likelihood is 5, obviously taking place. Overall impact is 5. Therefore, 5 into 5, it's 25. The scale is very high. Mitigation actions they have taken. Continue to assess the external environment for activities and products of competitors. Nothing relative to market performance. Continual investment in research and development. And vital. So one thing they can say is acquisition. They can acquire a company which is producing smartphone also. High chances are there. The litigation from the users Vita products. This is most likely to arise from the claim about product irritation. a product inaccuracy and could lead to cost, legal action or reputation damage. Likelihood is 2 and impact is 4, so totally 8. So in other words, irritation, plastic is there. So during the weather season like hot, it may be like burning. Robust products testing remains central to our ethos, our ethics, which immediate investigation, response and claims. And next thing, what about quality accreditation? They could have done a quality accreditation also, ISO like that, I'm generally telling you. Changes in global economy could impact the sales of profit, because I told you they are currently selling for 40 retailers globally. Fitness activity trackers are non-essential discretionary spend. Hence, sales are negatively affected by deterioration of global economy, recession. But I told you, this country is a very prosperous country, so people are able to spend. But let's assume a country where the people are finding it difficult to spend, there may be an issue. In exchange rate movements also. So 3 into 3, 9. So it's also a big one. So I told you a little bit of hedging you need to study. Hedging is very important, internal and external hedging techniques. We assess the global economy continually, look for signs of potential issues in the countries we supply, and we remain alert to the requirement to ensure our product offering and pricing is appropriate economic condition in the countries which we sell. Exchange rate issues are largely mitigated by hedging activities, so please keep that in mind. Data security, presence and ongoing challenge. The database that underpins all our information provision could be vulnerable to loss, disruption or theft or misuse. I told you, because their apps must be protected, because virus threat is there, hacking is there, so there can be misinterpretation also. So 3 and 4, the likelihood is 12. Our database is managed and protected by robust and experienced third party. Here see third party. The problem is third party supplier, but I say it's better to be an internal. Okay, so which is significant system to protect our security and data. Third party confidentiality issue also is there, so please keep that in mind. Our marketing activity utilizes social media. We are always aware, always at reputational risk if bad campaigns or publicity arise through social media. So 5-1 and it's 5. We monitor social media interaction constantly with dedicated resource and take action of negative publicity. So they are doing it social media, but what about word of mouth also? Word of mouth is more serious than social media. Low inventory or stock situation, I told you there is a situation now because our suppliers are becoming full capacity, arising from 2 key contract manufacturers operating at near full capacity. So 4 into 4, 16. The risk is continually assessed of conversion of 2 contract manufacturers are ongoing to ensure that they continue our demand. It is clear that we need to find the source of supply, rethink supply at the point of near future if the demand units continue to grow. Other potential manufacturers are plentiful, although unlikely to achieve it. Now, one more thing, everyone. I will just rank this. I'll just rank it with a different color pen, so it will be easy for you. So, if you look at this one, this is number 1, 25. This is number 2, supplier risk. This is number 3. This is number 4. This is number 5, and social media is number 6. This is the order they have given. So just be careful with this, everyone. Thank you. Now, everyone, let's move on to the senior leadership skill. I am telling you can just go through this, everyone, because one thing is this is just the names of the people they have given. But one thing I just wanted to keep in mind, if you look at this is the CEO, this is the COO. A non-executive chairwoman, this is the first time it's a chairwoman, just keep that in mind, it's a chairwoman. And Paul Post, Chief Financial Officer, Chief Technological Officer, so this person is very crucial. Chief Marketing Officer, Head of Human Resource, Non-Executive Director, good. And everyone, students, the financial analysis, I have just given the link below, where I have calculated all the ratios. You can just go through the link and you can find the slideshows available. Extracts are given. Students, just a summary of the explanation here. Now, they are telling at the moment office and hospitals are currently telling their employees and their clients to use these fitness devices to control their health. So this is an opportunity for us. whether we will be having future contracts, a tie-up with these companies. A tie-up can happen. And this is a legal case that is taking place where one company has given a poor heart rate count. So just keep that in mind. Even this can affect the industry overall. So one company has done bad in the industry can affect the other companies also, because people will be having a suspicion. So just be aware about it. These are sensitive things. And smartwatch market research news, they have given the new trend in the smartwatch, what has been taken place, everything. You can just go through that. And wearable tech health blog, they are telling for diabetes also, it's better to develop a smart tracking devices where you can identify the blood sugar rate. Now, these are the opportunities they have given. So just be aware about these things. And one more thing, students, before we brush up the session, I just want to keep it to updated. The next thing you need to be aware is, now everyone, if you look at the strategic case study, a technical skill is 25%, business skill is 25%, people skill is 25%, leadership skill is 25%. So overall, 100% is splitted like this. So just be aware about this, students, and good luck for your exams. Happy New Year, everyone. Take care.